Greetings, Cyberdogs and citizens of the interwebs! This is a blinged out Rendiggity Dog coming at you from deep within a cave network in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. Hi everybody, what's happening? Looks like that Moleshire special brew is still running through my veins, isn't it? I feel a little bit weird right now. But guys, I got some good news for you, man. I've been doing some caving in the mines of the dog this morning to get a little bit more iron for our brand new chicken farm project that we're working on. And I stumbled across a little something-something in this cave network. It is a spider spawner with a chest and a whole bunch of juicy, frickin' mossy cobblestone. And guess what's in this chest, my friends? Oh, it is a glorious day. A wonderful start to this episode. A wonderful start to the Rendiggity Dog weekend, because in the chest is a mending book. That is right, my friends. Our second mending book for the series. Absolutely amazing, man. This mending book is pretty serious business for us. We've only got one other mending book so far in the series, which we stuck onto our main pickaxe, Terra 1.1. And this secondary mending book is going to go straight onto Foreman, our secondary Silk Touch Efficiency 5 pickaxe. Which means now, unless we die and lose all of our tools in lava at some point, we will never break our pickaxes again in this series. And my friends, that is some magical news. Absolutely amazing. I'm super happy about that. Also, super happy about our Chicken Factory of Doom that we're going to be working on today, guys. Thank you, everybody, for the lovely comments in the previous episode. A lot of you guys were very impressed by my brain and my ability to figure out a very strange and interesting way to spawn chickens in the Moleshire. Today, we're going to start working a little bit more on that factory, my friends. See if we can get the actual chicken egg spittage mechanism installed. That's the plan for today. Looks like there's a little bit more cave action in here, too. And yeah, we are going to need quite a lot of iron and quite a few hoppers to get this done, actually. So I should probably look around here a little bit more, get a little bit more iron in the belly, and wow, this cave network actually goes all the way in there. There's a creeper back there. I'm not entirely sure whether I want to go jingle jangle with that creeper. Although, you know what? It is a beautiful day outside, guys. The sun is shining on my back in my studio right now. I'm feeling like a million bucks. So you know what? It's not even a creeper. It's just a little baby zombie. Get out of here, you stupid idiot. You can't even make me feel bad today, trying to kill me with your little freaking zombie hands, little baby zombie claws of doom. Shall we take a quick look what's down here, guys? Might as well, right? There might be another dungeon or something down here. No, it's just a giant cave network. Okay, duly noted. We shall be back here at some point to have a look at what's going on. I'm super excited though. Let's get this mending book onto Foreman ASAP. And I think to do that, we're going to need a butt ton of levels. I'm not even picking up any of this iron right now. Hold on. Let's not waste this, because that's what I'm down here for. But yeah, we're probably going to need at least 30 levels or so to get this mending book onto Foreman, because Foreman is a pretty formidable pickaxe. See what I did there? Foreman for formidable. Yeah, it's a terrible joke. Rendog, you stupid idiot. Don't make jokes. You're not a comedian, man. Oh, baby, the good news keeps on coming, Cyberdiggity Dogs. Can you see what I see at the end of this lava lake? Oh, baby, that looks like bling blangs to me. I was on my way home from the spider spawner. This is the tunnel that's going to take us back to the mines of the dog. And I spotted something in my peripheral over there. There is definitely some diamond action all the way at the end of this lava lake, isn't there? Let's do a little bit of obsidian pathway making 101. Nice and easy. And yes, that definitely looks like some bling blangs. That is how I like to start a morning of Minecrafting, guys. A mending book and some diamonds in the belly. Does a day of Minecrafting get any better than that? Is there any more than that? Is that seriously just one diamond ore? Okay, well, it's not the greatest haul of diamonds, but you know what? I'm not going to complain. Any bling blangs in the belly makes me happy. Yeah, let's get over to the Spider-Matic, guys. Get this mending book on Foreman. That's a nice surprise, Cyberdiggity Dogs. Only 17 XP needed to put mending onto Foreman. So that's absolutely amazing. I think I'll take that, man. That is quite a bargain. Also, I'd like to get Terra up to efficiency 5, because at the moment, Terra's on efficiency 4. So I've made another efficiency 4 book here, and that's going to take us 12 XP to do that. So we can do Terra in a moment. But take a look at this, guys. Now that we got Mending on Foreman and Terra, we are going to be able to... Oops, that's the wrong button. We are going to be able to repair both of our tools at the same time here in the Spider-Matic, right? So what we can do is slay some of these spiders. And when those XP balls start to roll in, we can put the pickaxes in each of our hands. And slowly but surely, they will get repaired by the Mending, which is absolutely awesome. Oh my goodness, now we can repair both of our tools really, really quickly. This is really sweet, guys. We don't have to worry about pickaxes now. Until, of course, one day we die in lava and they get melted, which, let's face it, is probably going to happen at some point. Anyway, I want to get efficiency onto Terra. There we go. 12 in the belly. And I also want to rename Terra, actually. I'm not really happy with Terra's name. At the moment, we're calling Terra Terra 1.1. And I don't know. It's just kind of messing with me at the moment. I think what we're going to do is we're going to name this Terra 2, right? Because this is going to be the second version of Terra, and that's going to be an efficiency 5, fortune 3 pickaxe. So get in the belly, Terra 2. Nice. Foreman 2 is our silk touch. Terra is our fortune 3. They've both got mending on it, and if you ask me, my friends, that is freaking awesome. So much awesomeness kicking off today's episode, my friends. It has been a great morning of Minecraft so far, man. Brand new freaking mending pickaxe in the belly. Got a whole bunch of iron here to smelt. Oh, baby, feeling really, really good. Now, today, we are going to be working a little bit more on the chicken farm of doom. But before we get to that, guys, there is a little mini project that I would like to get sorted. Something that I've been thinking about for quite a while, and something that's going to be kind of interesting, I think. This is going to be pretty fun. Let's get this iron into the auto smelter over here. Just get all of this cooked up. We've got a little bit of gold here, too. And that's going to get nicely smelted and stored in our facility. Hi, Griswold. How's the hangover, my brother? You're feeling a little bit woozy there. Have some water, man. You need it. You look absolutely terrible. Anyway, there's something that's been bothering me a little bit about the fields of the dog over here, guys. So this is where we originally started off collecting food and whatnot in the series. And what I was doing here is literally just breaking the crops and replanting them and collecting all of the wheat and the potatoes and everything that grows here. But one thing that's been bothering me is the mission. Wow, that is loud. Jeez. One thing that's been bothering me is the mission of getting all of the stuff that I harvest from the fields of the dog down into the storage hole. It's a little bit of a tedious task, right? And what I thought we could do today is try and automate the collection of the wheat process. Now, a few episodes ago, actually quite a few episodes ago, I think it was about 20 episodes ago or so, we created an item aqueduct flowing from the Moleshire, or sorry, from the mole hole into the storage hole, right? There is actually an aqueduct down here that takes all of the sugarcane coming from our sugarcane farm into the storage hole. Now, what I'm thinking is that maybe what we could do is connect up the fields of the dog to this item aqueduct, right? Do I have any blocks on me? No, all right, we're gonna have to break some blocks here. But what we could potentially do here, guys, is create a connection from the fields of the dog to that item aqueduct and thus start delivering the crops from the fields of the dog directly into the storage facility. Does that make sense? Now, we've already got something pretty cool happening here in the fields of the dog, and that is a little bit of a stream. And what I thought we could do, which could be pretty cool, is make the stream completely flowing. So off camera, I've made the stream completely flow all the way down here so that wherever we throw a bit of croppage, that croppage is going to flow and follow this river all the way down. It's a little bit slow, but it eventually will flow all the way down. I made a little bridge here also out of dirt just so that I could keep the water level high enough to actually give water to the crops. And I thought what we could do is all the way down here somewhere, so I'm thinking maybe in this position here, we could create a tunnel that is going to connect up to that item aqueduct coming from the mole hole, right? So eventually those items are going to flow through here and end up in this position over here. Can they actually flow through there, or did I block that off? That looks like it's blocked off, isn't it? Hold on, let me get my shovel up in here, and let's move this block away. There we go. There is that bit of croppage that we threw in. So eventually the crops will flow down the river and end up in this position. And what we could do is dig down and create a water aqueduct that is going to connect up with our item system, right? I think that's pretty sweet. Then all I have to do is harvest the crops up here and then throw them into the river at any point along the stream, and eventually they will end up in the storage hole. So what we're going to need to do is figure out how to connect up this position here to our item aqueduct. So let's stand on this block, and what we're going to have to do is follow this block all the way down without moving. Okay, so this is the block line. This is where that item elevator or item aqueduct is going to flow, and it's going to end up, I believe, over here. And the very center of the aqueduct coming from the mole hole is in, it's in line with the door over here. Okay, so here is where we need to create our connection. And I suppose what we're going to need to do is go underneath here. Hi, Victoria and Maximus. Don't mind me, okay? We're just doing a little bit of technical Minecraft over here. Get back to your business of eating food. What we should be able to do is dig down in this position, and this should take us directly into this aqueduct. Yes, it does. All right, sweet. So, next thing we can do is work out exactly where to go from here. Okay, there we go. Is that in line? Yes, it is. All right, sweet. So, all we need to do now is create an item aqueduct that is going to flow all the way from the fields of the dog to this channel. And that should automate the collection of our croppage. Nice! Turns out this item aqueduct isn't quite as straightforward as I thought it was going to be, guys. What I'm trying to do here is dig directly back toward the field of the dog. But there's actually a ravine system over here, which makes it a little bit tricky. And of course, what makes it a little bit more tricky is that we are not allowed to use F3 in this series, right? We can't use the debug mode. Also, there seems to be a skeleton spawner over here. I think we probably discovered this one already, haven't we? Yeah, looks like it. I don't know where that skeleton came from, though. Jeez. He was a little bit aggressive. What I need to do here, of course, is to figure out exactly where the fields of the dog are. And I think it's probably somewhere up here. So what I'd like to do is just to create the aqueduct as long as possible. And then we'll dig down from the field of the dog and land into the aqueduct. And what we want to do, of course, too, is make sure that each of these levels is about 7 blocks long so that the water can flow to the very edge. Yeah, this water source flows all the way to the edge here to connect up to the main aqueduct. And now we can just keep making layers like that all the way in that direction, and eventually we'll end up underneath the fields of the dog, and that way we can figure out exactly where we are in the world, right? Little bit of a tedious process, of course. It would be much easier just to use F3, but hey, where's the fun in that, am I right? So, theoretically speaking, that aqueduct is now running directly underneath here, and if we just dig down in this position, we should eventually just fall into the aqueduct, and we could use this water source that we're getting from the river above us too, which could be pretty useful. But yeah, we're gonna have to see if we connect into this aqueduct. If we just keep on digging and nothing happens, well, then we made a little bit of an error. There we go, there's the aqueduct. Okay, so we were a few blocks too far, it looks like it. And we also have this water now flowing down here, which is a little bit of a concern. Maybe what we can do is use this water source as the primary water source to push the items down this aqueduct. So let's make a bit of a wall here behind this waterfall thing that's going on. Hang on. Is it flowing from there? Yes, it is. All right, so there we go. This is going to be our primary water source, and that's going to flow into here, and hopefully that hasn't messed up the water stream. No, it hasn't. Okay, so the theory is now, if we harvest the fields of the dog, chuck all of those beautiful crops into the water stream, they will just automagically end up in the storage hole. I mean, that's the theory, and hopefully it actually freaking works. Only one thing left to do for this mini project, my friends, and that is to put the whole system to the test. Am I right? Just finished harvesting the fields of the dog here. Got my inventory full of delicious, tasty, freaking croppage. And the theory is we could probably throw all of this croppage into this waterfall coming out the side of the mountain. And all of these goods should end up eventually in the storage hole, right? So let's throw everything in there, including these pumpkins and whatnot. And yeah, it's taken a little bit of a while. They sort of get pushed around the corner, but eventually they get going. And we can see all of those crops flowing down the stream. Oh, that is actually really sweet. I mean, this is kind of a pointless project, to be honest with you. But I just thought it would be really cool, man. And let's have a look. All the items should be flowing down there. Yes, there they go, dropping all the way down. Are they actually moving down there? It looks like it. Yeah, they're not getting stuck on that block down there, so that's good. And if it's all been done correctly, guys, we should see croppage now flowing into the storage hole collection mechanism, right up that item elevator in the middle of the storage hole. Let's go and take a look. Hopefully this has worked. Is this chest full? Yes, it is completely full of stuff from the mines of the dog. Let's clear up a little bit of space over here. We're about to have the arrival of some crops. Hopefully hopefully, if we've done it correctly, we should see crops popping out of this little hopper here at any moment now. Come on, Minecraft, you can do it. Where are the crops? Is this broken? Is this system broken? It shouldn't be taking this long. There she blows, my friends. The beautiful crops are flowing up through the system. Also pushing some of the other items that are stuck at the bottom there up also. And that is absolutely awesome, guys. That is freaking sweet, man. Fields of the Dog are now, well, automated, kind of. And we can send all of our crops into the storage hole. And it saves us a few minutes of time every day. Very good. Welcome back, fans of roast chicken dinners, to Rendog's Poultry Factory of Doom and Destruction and Automatic Egg Cracking. That's what we're doing out here, my friends. Let's get going on our beautiful little poultry farm that we started in the previous episode. Actually, there's nothing beautiful about it at the moment. It is a complete and utter mess. But in the previous episode, we did manage to figure out a way to spawn chickens out of eggs automagically, right? And as you can see, a bunch of new baby chickens have arrived around here, just naturally and from the egg machine spitting the eggs out. Let's have a quick recap, shall we? It's a very interesting machine, which I'm a big fan of. Basically, the way that this thing works is that chickens sitting on top of this hopper will poop out an egg, and that egg will flow through the hopper chain and trigger this comparator. And when it does, the eggs that are inside of this dispenser are going to get shot up into the air, and when they land, they will break and potentially make some more chickens. Let me demonstrate. There go the eggs getting spat out by the dispenser, and man, that is so awesome. And then the eggs will fall down, and we can see a couple of baby chickens being spawned there from that. So that's pretty sweet. Now, what we're going to try and do, guys, is get this part of the chicken factory, so the egg production part of the factory over here. And then what we'll do is get all of those eggs flowing down into the organic part of our farm here, which is where the chickens get to hang out. This is where they're going to get born, right? Or where the eggs are going to crack. So, I guess let's get cracking. I haven't really thought very much on how I want this project to work or how I want this project to look, but just very briefly looking at the area that we're working with here, we're probably going to have to make this into a gobbet hole of some kind, much like we did with the blacksmith hole, right? Maybe what we could do is build this chicken egg factory part. I guess this is the egg chamber, the chicken factory egg production chamber. I guess we could make that in a cave over here, which could be pretty sweet. So let's clear out all of this land to start off with, and then we can sort of build up around it once again, right? And with the dirt grinder, we could very easily just munch through this dirt like it ain't no thing, baby. Get out of here, dirt. And yeah, we'll probably have to rebuild this little mountaintop at the end, but that's fine. Okay, so this has given us a little bit of space for our egg chamber section of the poultry factory, and I suppose all we need to do is sort of emulate what we did there in the center for our tests. And I guess what we need to do is try and just make this as nice looking as possible. So if we sort of find the center of this area here, it's probably around here, I guess, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 on that side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's perfect. So this is going to sort of be the entrance into our egg chamber. And I guess what we could do is set up some of these things over here, right? So maybe we'll try and set up like 4 or 5 of them. Do I have any blocks to do this? Yeah, we do have some planks and some freaking slabs and whatnot in here. I think what we're going to have to do, though, guys, something that I noticed about this particular farm is that we're not going to be able to put fences around the hopper to keep the chickens in, unfortunately, because the eggs that come out of the chickens can actually land on the blocks that fences are on, and we want all the eggs to land in the hoppers, right, that come out of the chicken butts. So we're going to have to do this in a different way, I think, and that was cute, but very wrong, Ren Diggity Dog. Okay, so this is the center of our egg production chamber of Chicken Factory Alpha. And I guess what we could do is just start laying down a few foundations. So this is going to be the entrance here. Maybe the entrance will be a little bit further back. Maybe that'll be the entrance here, right? So this is where the door of the factory is going to be. And when we come inside here, maybe we'll have like I don't know, let's do like threes. This is, I mean, this is how big one of our egg production units is going to be, right? It's going to be a 3x3 like this. How many 3x3s can we actually squeeze in here? Probably not that many, right? We could probably squeeze 4, which makes me feel like maybe we need to make this a triple story factory. Maybe we need to have multiple levels up here, perhaps. Because, well, we're only going to have one chicken in each thing. Although what we could do, I suppose, is just ram a bunch of chickens into each of the hoppers, right? That could work out pretty good, actually. Although it would be horrendously cruel, of course. But, you know, we might have to turn a blind eye for this one, guys. Because this is the only way we're going to be able to produce a bunch of eggs for our chicken farm, right? So, our chickens are going to be chilling inside the center of these cubes over here, or these cells. And they'll be sitting on top of these hoppers pooping out eggs. And those eggs will, I guess, be collected in a central chamber of a hopper chain, which I guess will run down the very center of the factory and connect up with the egg spitter down there, right? And we probably want to go one block down too, just so that we can cover up the hoppers so that we don't actually see them. So let's go one block further down, and then we can connect up there. So there's the hopper for that one, and here's the hopper for this one. This is going to be a horrendously cruel farm, guys. I'm just thinking about it now. Oh my goodness, man. Listen, animal lovers, please don't judge me on this one, okay? I'm just trying to make an efficient chicken farm in Minecraft. That's all. The chickens in this chamber, they're going to have a miserable life, there's no doubt. But they're going to be feeding the Moletown Nation, okay? Their sacrifice will not go in vain. This chicken knows what's up, guys. He knows the fate of his existence is in jeopardy right now. He's desperate to get back into the organic section. My dude, it's your fault, man. It's your fault that you left the pen. It's not my problem, man. You're going to get stuck in one of these cages. Anyway, I've been working a bit more on the layout out here, guys. I've spread apart the egg chambers a little bit, and I think that gives us a bit more space in the center to work on that. And what I thought we could do is switch up the planks over here for some oak planks instead of just spruce, right? I think that looks pretty cool. And maybe what we could do is just throw some stairs in here too, just to add a little bit of detail into it. You know, these are, of course, chicken coops that the gobbets aren't exactly going to spend a lot of time looking after, and there's going to be holes in them and stuff, and they're going to be a little bit busted up and whatnot. So I kind of like adding a few of these little holes in here, right? I think it's also going to be really sweet that we have these different planks, because what we could do is use some spruce wood slabs to add like a roof on top of these little pens, which I think looks cool, these little chicken coops. So we could add a little lip like that, right? That looks pretty sweet. I like that. Maybe we can work on a little bit more detail for that in the upcoming episodes. But yeah, this is where we are going to be trapping the chickens, and I think I probably want to get cow and chicken in here. I know that they are awesome and called cow and chicken and should very much be in the organic side of things, but we are going to be coming out here and killing the chickens for some roast chicken out here, and I don't want to kill cow or chicken. So they're actually ironically going to be much safer in the actual egg pen itself. I suppose this chicken that we've got over here can be our first prisoner though, can't he? Let's see if we can get him in here. I think I got a seed on me right now, and I want to see if I can trap him in there with a slab. I think that's going to be quite important. So, oh, it's actually cow! Cow, how did you get out of the pen? I think I must have broken a block or something and he sort of climbed under the fences. Or she. I think cow is actually a she, by the way. Come on, cow. You can get in here. I know you don't particularly want to, but you're going to have to, okay? You're going to be safe and sound in this place. It's not exactly a beautiful place to live. No, you stupid idiot chicken. Come down here, please. Hello, cow, my dude. You need to get your butt down into the bottom section. Oh, okay. Let's try this again, shall we? Let's get up here. Come on. Come on. You know you want to. Come on, cow. You can do it. Come on. Oh, there we go. There we go, little cutie. There we go. Boom. Get trapped. Get trapped. Okay, so the chicken is in the coop. Is it a coo or a coop? I think it's a coop, right? And what I'd like to do is just add a slab here if I can. No, we can't. Cow, you frickin' idiot! That ended up being way derpier than it needed to be, guys, but I've managed to get Cow into her chicken pen over here, and I'm very curious to see if she can get through this half a slab. I don't think she can. Can you get out of there, Cow? Is it possible for you to get under that slab? No, it's not. Okay, so she's literally trapped in there right now. Oh, man. I do feel kind of bad. I'm not gonna lie, guys, but what has to be done has to be done. That is the chicken in the coop, and I guess we can actually feed her through here, can't we? I think we'll probably be able to. Let's have a look. I think we'll probably have to get down here. No, we can't. Okay. Oh my goodness. That is really sad. She's going to sit there in for eternity and poop out eggs into this hopper. And that hopper is eventually going to connect up to all the other hoppers that are eventually going to start spitting eggs out in the organic side of the factory. But yeah, we need to fill up all of these coops now with chickens. We need to get chicken over here also. And maybe we'll stick three or four chickens into each of the coops so we can get the eggs cooking nice and quickly. But unfortunately, guys, we're going to have to wait till the next episode to get that done. We have run out of time for today. I'll spend the rest of this afternoon getting all of this project sort of ready for us to complete in the next episode. But guys, I hope you have enjoyed it, man. If you have, you know what to do. You smackity smack that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, well, you hit the subscribe button. If not for me, but for the sake of the chickens who are now going to be trapped for eternity here in the poultry factory of doom. Oh man, thanks for watching, guys. Ren Diggity Dog signing out. We'll smell you all in the next episode.